welcome. Thank you for being here.
Good to be here.
I want to congratulate you.
Look at that.
We're excited to see you.
Wow. Yeah.
Happy
That's
spring
for
break. That's right.
Science.
That's for science and Bob.
Wow.
How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Well,
yeah.
Show us some of the stuff that you've been working on.
All right. So I figured we start with a do-at-home experiment.
Well, great. That's fun.
Something you can do with the kids when you get home.
Okay.
Really easy. You need just three things. Mm-hmm. You need a fan, standard old fan.
Have one of those.
Now, you do need to remove the front, which is basically removing all the safety features of the fan.
Okay, great.
So just keep that in mind.
Okay.
You need some toilet paper.
We have that.
And then you just need some tape, and that's about it.
Great.
All right. So really, so you remove the front of this. We're going to bring this actually around on the floor. It's a little easier on the floor. You can come around front here.
Okay.
And we're going to face that straight up. And I'm going to have you come over here.
All right.
And I'm going to give you one end of the toilet paper.
Okay.
And we are going to gently pull out about 15 feet of this.
All right.
All right. It's a little more.
This is a big step in our relationship, Bob.
All right, there we go. And I'm going to have you just...
Yeah, that's about how much I use.
I'm going to have you... It's easiest if this is up higher. So I'm going to have you step back a little bit and just kind of hold it so it's off the ground and maybe even above your head a little bit.
All righty.
All right. And then I'm going to tape one end...
Oops, sorry.
Oh, that's okay. It's all right. It's all good. I'm going to tape one end...
It's like a CVS receipt, right?
Yeah.
Same thing.
All right, so I've got one end on the fan, and I'm going to turn the fan on, and then we're just you're just going to let it slip through your hands.
Okay.
And here's the science behind this.
All right.
You've got two forces at work here on a fan. You've got the centripetal force, which wants to go that way, and then you've got the centripetal force creating a vertical force, which is the wind blowing out.
Okay.
Normally, you don't get to see these two forces working together, so we're going to try to visualize
Finally,
that.
They come together.
Finally, in a cool visual way. All right, here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
And let's see. I think we're ready. All right, let go, 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 let go.
Oh.
It's kind of neat. So here we go. I'm going to very slowly attempt to bring this back up onto the table without it self-destructing.
Uh-huh.
And if all goes well, I should be able to actually turn it and go horizontal with this.
Wow, look at that. I like that. It looks great. It's pretty nifty.
Yeah. So I thought we'd create our first Jimmy Kimmel hashtag. So if anyone tries this at home, hashtag it toilet paper tornado.
Oh, and, we'll that was my wrestling name.
Yeah.
All right, there you go. All right.
All right,
very
let's
good.
Some more. Let's come on back here. All right, we're going to start off over here.
Well, this is the saddest birthday party ever, isn't it?
All right, believe it or not, we're going to gear up for these balloons.
Okay,
here.
I like when we gear up.
All right, so. A little bit of interesting science. I've gotten some people who have been confused by a sign that they've seen in a hospital. And the sign reads, no smoking, oxygen in use.
Okay.
Which would make you come to the conclusion that oxygen is flammable.
Oxygen is not flammable.
Well, that's what we're going to find out.
Oh, okay.
All right. So 100% pure oxygen. And this is my world's tiniest tiki torch here.
Okay.
So, I've got a lighter, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna find out if oxygen is in fact flammable. I'll light this, you're gonna bring it up to the oxygen balloon, and we don't need these just yet.
Okay.
And if it explodes, we'll have an answer. If not, we'll know it's not flammable. All right,
all
so there we go. We light that one,
do
bring it.
It
over, 100% oxygen. Yeah, I know, kinda sad.
Yeah.
All right, now, we're gonna come back to this in a second. We're gonna come back to the oxygen. But right now, I've got this one, which is 100% hydrogen.
Okay.
Now, we've played with hydrogen before.
Oh, yeah, hydrogen's fun, yeah.
Yeah, hydrogen's fun because hydrogen is flammable. So I'm going to hold the end of that.
Uh-huh.
We're going to see what 100% hydrogen looks like. We might want to put these on now.
Okay, but what about nobody in the audience, has these?
You probably want to cover your ears a little bit, all right?
All right.
Terrific. Here we go. 100% hydrogen meets fire. There we go. That was good. All right. So, now... Let's answer the question as to why they have those signs in the hospital, even though oxygen is not flammable. In this balloon, we have two parts hydrogen and one part oxygen. So we take that hydrogen balloon that just blew up, but now we're going to give it a good source of oxygen. And we're gonna see if it burns any differently.
Mm-hmm.
This one, folks, you are definitely gonna want to cover up your ears.
Okay.
All right, good. All right, they seem ready. This one's for you. Here we go.
See, they weren't covering their ears, I could tell. All right.
All right, here we go. So this is 2 parts hydrogen, 1 part oxygen. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1.
Wow, it's like, the Space Force. Yeah. That's pretty cool.
I'm guessing they felt that.
I can feel that,
yeah. You can feel that. So, that's why you don't want oxygen anywhere near.
This is how the
fire.
Old man in Up died.
Oh, no. All right.
All right, what else do we
Come
have?
Come on over here.
Science Bob.
All right, so here we have kind of a cool invention.
Yes, all right.
This is known as a vacuum cannon.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to bring you around here. And here's basically how this works. It's a simple design. It's pretty simple. We have a clear PVC tube.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the tube are two mylar, which is like little plastic ends to it.
Right.
Okay? And we have a vacuum pump. So this, instead of pushing air into it, is going to suck the air out of it. Now, what you're going to do at the right time is you're going to pierce this membrane on the end.
Do it now?
Oh, not yet.
Okay.
And all of the air is going to rush in very, 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 very quickly. So we figured, what's the nerdiest thing that you could do with an air cannon? And we just came up with the idea, is it possible to send Superman literally faster than a speeding bullet?
Yeah.
I mean, that would be cool, right?
I mean, it's how the intro goes, sure.
Yeah, and we're going to see what happens when we send Superman faster than a speeding bullet into a brick wall.
Okay, all right, here we go.
Let's do it. We're going to crank this up. There we go. You might want these.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, so everyone plug their ears
again,
huh?
Yeah, plug your ears again.
Wow.
All right, I'm going to check the meter over here. Oh, by the way, our piercing device. There you go. All right, we're still lowering. All right, come on around this end, and you're just going to hit it right in the middle when it's time.
All right.
All right, Superman is ready. Here we go. Superman at the speeding bullet speed. Oh. Wait, let's go see. Let's see, you got it. Let's see what's left of Superman. Almost went through.
Oh! Superman's dead, everybody! Oh, my God!
Oh, yeah.
Wow, let's look at the replay here and see what happened to Superman. Somehow, Science Bob managed to out Lex Luthor here.
All right, Bob, I love it when you give me a giant blaster like this. What's going on? What is this called?
So we got a pressure release over here. So when you pull on the trigger, that's going to move a valve over here, which is going to throw all of this air down this barrel.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the barrel is filled with a number of cucumbers.
And then,
at the end of the barrel is 8 stainless steel razor sharp blades.
Oh.
So the idea is that
we can... That seems like a great idea.
Yeah, see, it's great. So the idea is that, I don't know, 3 cucumbers might take you, what, 5 minutes to chop?
Yeah, something like that.
We're going to try to do it in 20 microseconds.
All right, here we go.
So here we go. You're going to point it at our little salad chute there, which should gather all of our ingredients.
Tell me when.
All right, ready? 3, 2, 1. See that?
Wow. Let's see, have a look at that. And that doesn't seem practical, but.
Yeah. See?
It looks delicious. Yeah.
Now. The next one, what if we could create an entire salad?
Oh, that was the little one.
Come on down here.
All right.
All right. So.
Wow, it does smell like cucumber in here.
So let me show you what we got here.
All right.
So we've got a number of various salad components, from lettuce to peppers, and that will be able to make our salad.
Wow.
Now, you're going to need to lower your mask for
this. Okay, I'm going to lower my mask.
We also have your electronic menu here.
Carrots, apples, tomatoes.
Just flip on what you'd like in your salad.
Well, I want everything in it.
Oh, all right.
All right, let's put in everything in salad.
There we go. Great.
All right.
All right, now. Flip that switch, that's going to arm it.
I flip that up.
Now everything is armed.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Hit that button.
I'm ready, here we go. Whoa! Wow! Look at that. Science Bob Flufelder. Check him out on Instagram at Science Bob.
If you like that video, then put a ring on it. Click the subscribe button below.